Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. In this video, we are going to see about top 10 widgets that you might not hear of in Flutter. So without any delay, let's get started. Now let's have a look at vertical divider widget. So for that, I'll just having the center on inside the size box, I'll just given the height 200 and I'll given a vertical divider as the child and given the color as a gray. So if I just save this, as you can see, the divider is like showing in a vertically, and you can also, I'll just change the color to make it more visible, and you can also change the thickness here as 0.5. Okay, 0.9. Yeah, see, let's make it as a gray itself. Yeah, it looks fine. Now let's have a look at the table widget in Flutter. So I'll just creating the table here. So table widget just creates a table for us, so we can just define the rows and columns and all the other attributes are there. And I'm just giving the border color, I just make it to gray color. And inside the children, I'm just giving the all the table rows here. So what are the rows you want to give? So you might heard of the data table widget, and there is also a table widget is also there. So you can just give the table rows inside this, and I just save this, and you can see the output. So this is how you can just create a table by using the table widgets also. Now let's have a look at the rotated box widget. So inside this column, I'll just have an elevator button here. Give a text widget to the child. So you can have the elevator button here. Okay. So now I will wrap this widget with the rotated box widget. So quarter turns is a required field for the rotated box widget. So one quarter turn is 90 degrees. So you can, for now I'll just give a 3. You can see the output now. See, it has rotated the widget itself. So you can have a whatever the widget you want to rotate. So you can just wrap it with the rotated box and give the quarter turns of each. So it will just rotate it accordingly. So the beauty of this widget is, so if I give the container of the widget, I'll just see the contained space of the widget. So no matter which direction it rotates, it will just occupy that space alone. It's not occupying the horizontal space of it. So that's the beauty of it. Even if you give the quarter turn 0, so it will just occupy this thing. So that's the beauty of the rotated box widget. Now let's have a look at the expansion time widget. So instead of column, I'll just have the expansion tile widget. So inside that, I'm just giving the title as a click me to expand text widget, and I'll be giving the children. So if I save this, you can see the output. This click me is expanded. So this is that like a drop down thing. So if you click this, it will be expanding and showing the list of widget that we are given here. Not only text, you can give a what are all the widgets you want to show it there. So if you again click this, so it will be collapsing. So we also having the lots of attributes here, like collapsed icon color, collapsed text color. It's initially expanded. If you want to expand it whenever the UI comes, so you can also do that. Non-expansion change on the text color, and we having the leading and trial widgets also for this. So this is the expansion tile widget in Flutter. Now let's have a look at the observe pointer widget in Flutter. So first of all, the observe pointer is used to it will just restrict the user to click the what are all the widgets which is presented in the screen. It will restrict them to interact with those widgets. So we'll see how to do that. So into the column, I'm having those observe pointer widget. So I've given the value called is observe false initially. Variable I have declared here. So I'm gonna pass it is observing is the attribute we should pass to the observe pointer widget. So inside the child widget, I'm just giving the elevator button and I'm just printing the I'm clicked text whenever we pressed on the on elevator button. And I'll be having the floating action button. And inside that, I'm just changing the observe that local variable value here. And I'm just updating the state. That's it. Now we'll see the output. So as you can see, just open the console. So it is come. So whenever I click the click me button, it's just clicked on the console. See here. Right now it's printed once. So it's 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 times it was printed. So I have clicked 5 times. Okay. So now I'm changing the value whenever we press on the floating action button. If I just click this button, so the value will be changed into true. So observe will be activated. So it won't let us click on the those widgets which is presented in the screen. So now let's try that. So if I just try to click the click B button, as you can see, only 5 is there. It's not even incrementing. So it has been restricted. So after I change the value, I just press the floating action button. So now the value will be changed to false. Now you see the value is changing 6, 7, 8. So yeah, that's how that observe pointer works. So in real world scenario where we can use this widget is whenever we have a form, we'll be having the loading state. So we'll be showing the progress indicator between the forms. So whenever the progress indicator is occurring, so we should restrict user to interact with those fields. So since it has been already submitted, so in that case we can also use the observe pointer widget where I am also using that. Now let's have a look at the overflow bar widget. I'll just inside the column, I'll just create a row here. Inside the row, I'll have a container, the height of 150 and the width of 50. I'll just give a color. So after that, I'll give a one more container here. Give a color to green. Okay. Yeah. I'll just on the emulator. Puppet is there. Let me change the console to debug console. Okay. Let's change it. So yeah, so we have two containers inside the row. I'll just copy this. So if I have one more container with red, so it will overflow in the row. So since we don't have a space inside the row, so it's just overflowing. So for this scenario, we can change the row into overflow bar. So what it will do is it will just whenever the overflow is occurs, it will just change that row into the column and the column into the row. So vice versa, that's how the overflow bar is works. And you can also give the spacing in between that. Give a 20. For run spacing, we'll have a overflow spacing. Give a 20.
So you can get the vertical spacing and the horizontal spacing, and you can also give the alignment also, overflow alignment, and click behavior and overflow direction, that also you can give it. So this is the use of overflow bar in the this scenario. Now let's have a look at toggle buttons widget in Flutter. So I'll just create a center widget here. So inside the center, toggle buttons widget is there. So inside that, you have to give the children of the widgets. So and I've created the selected items list here. So list of bool, we have to give it to the toggle buttons. So for selected items. And so each selector, I've given the selector item list here, and there will be a parameter called onPressed. So whenever you press the some button, so it will give you the index of the button. So by using the index, you can change the value of the selector items list, boolean value, and after that I'll just update the state. Yeah, so now we'll see the output. Now I'll just load it. Okay, so this is how the toggle button widget looks like. So you have to given the list of widgets, so it will just give you this. And once you click on the some particular button, it looks it will make it as a selected one. So if you again click this, so it will be unselected one. So you can also change the color of the selector fill color and the border color and the radius of the constraints and the disabled border and focus color, and you can even change the hover color also for web. So yeah, so this is how the toggle button works. Now let's have a look at the backdrop filter widget. So inside the column, just give the center widget. Inside that, I'll just put a stack here. So inside the stack, I just given the image asset as a dash image, and after that I will just give the backdrop filter. So first of all, the backdrop filter is used to, like, if you want to apply some filters to some images or some widgets, so you want to apply some blur effect and something else, so you can use the backdrop filter widget. And by using this, and you can also have that image filter class in the Flutter. So by using those classes, so you can achieve that filter thing. So inside the filter, I've just given the image filter, so dot blur. So I've given the 10-10 value as a x and y. So inside the child, I've just given the empty container. So if I save this file, you can see the blur effect on the image file. So you, as you can see, you can also change the value of the blur on the as much as you want. You can just give that. So this is the backdrop filter widget in Flutter. Now let's have a look at the value listenable builder widget in Flutter. So I'll just give the center widget. Inside that value listenable builder is the widget. So first of all, the value listenable builder is a used to update the value, like no matter how many widgets you have, the you want to update in your app. So at the same time, without even calling the state changes, it just update the seamlessly to the respective widgets. So now we'll see how to do that. So we have to give the value listenable notifier here. So here I'm having the counter variable, so I'm just given the value notifier. So our notifier should be given in value listenable. And after that, there will be a attribute called builder, which will have the context and value on child. So this value will be coming, that updated value will be comes here. So I'm just given the text widget. Inside that, I just printed the given the value that is returned by the builder. And I'm gonna have the floating action button. So inside onPress, I'll just increment the counter value, and I just assign the value notify value to counter. That's it. I'm not calling any other state changes here. I'm not even calling the set state here. I just given the value to the counter. So now we'll see how it works. So here, since the initial index is 0, so the 0 prints here. So if I click the fab. So it start incrementing whenever I press the button. It's just calling across all the state management. So even even we'll have the multiple listenable builder for the same value too. So for now I'll just first remove this. I'm gonna given the same thing here. We'll make it a center. Okay, so I'll just refresh this. So initial value of the two widget is a zero only. So whenever I click the button, so it starts changing the two widgets at the same time. So for example, if you want to implement this in your real-time project, if you want to change the like if you have a social media application developed by developer in Flutter, so if you want to update the user profile picture at the time when you will be having that section in our option sections or see profile section. So whenever user updates the profile picture, it should reflect the latest profile picture which is having in throughout the app. So for that scenario, you can easily use the value listenable builder, so it will be very helpful for that cases. Now let's have a look at mouse region widget in Flutter. This widget is especially for Flutter web, so I have run the project in Flutter web, so we'll see how to do that and how it will helps. So I'll just have the container here. Inside the container, I'll just have a text called click me. So I'll just make it a center. So yeah, I'll just run this code. As you can see, the output, the click me text is at the center. And just see the cursor, the mouse pointer carefully. This widget is especially is for the mouse pointer. So as you can see, this is only if I hover on the click me, so it just having the same pointer, that arrow thing. So if you want to change that to something else, so for example, first I'll just wrap this container with the mouse region. So inside the cursor there is a system mouse cursor thing, and I'll just make it as a click system mouse dot click. So I'll just run this. As you can see, I'll just see right now it's in arrow pointer. I'll just over on the click me button, so it just changed into the hand symbol. So this is how that the mouse region widget is very special. Whichever the widget you want to make the thing to change the mouse cursor, means you can easily achieve that by using the mouse region. So right now it's a hand symbol. So if you want to use something else, like if you want to hide something, like there is a forbidden thing, so I'll just run this. So if you over on the click menu, so it does show that cross mark, and if you want to show the progress thing, that thing also is there. Second, it's a progress. So the progress indicator is comes along with the arrow mark. So this the progress thing, and you can also have lots of thing here which you can easily this one is for copy. So if you hold this, see the plus button is coming. So this is how the mouse region widget is very, very useful. And that's the end of the video, guys. There are still plenty of widgets out there in Flutter. So for now, I have just picked 10 among it. So if you have any unique widgets, like if I've used in your project, and do let us know in comment section, so that it could help others to learn some new widgets every time. So that's all for the today's video, guys. We'll see you in next video. Stay tuned. Bye.